सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां व्यासाय विष्णुरूपाय व्यासरूपाय विष्णवे नमो वै ब्रह्मनिधये वासिष्ठाय नमो नमः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम् शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः समस्तजनकल्याणे करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं हरि ओम. So we have studied the mutual superimposition, like how fire and iron ball come together and make this mutual superimposition. And after that, one more thought we brought, that is a three dimension. The next one is two dimension, how the superimposition of snake on rope, a superimposition of silver on shell. We did that also. You understood very clearly. And now, so in that section, we have seen other philosophies, the views of other philosophies. This view is called what? The theory of error, khyativada. Atma khyati, asat khyati, akhyati. So you are telling very nicely. It is there. Great students. Systematically you told, very good. It is very clearly. Atma khyati, asat khyati, akhyati, anyata khyati. So atma khyati is it. The vijnanavadi, the mind is everything. Everything is in the mind. There is no object outside. This is the philosophy finished, you understood. Next, asat khyati. Should. Nothing is there. Nothing outside, nothing inside. Nothing inside. Nothing. Suppose you see that is error. So according to our view, there is no object outside, inside. If anything is seen, that is non-existence. Shunyavad. Akhyati, according to Prabhakara Mimamsa. What he says, this is also real, that is also real. Because of my non-discrimination, I misunderstood this as that. That's all. Very simple. Then the Nyaya theory comes. Anyata khyati. So this is real. And what I had, the earlier experience, that is real. But the memory, what I had about the snake, this memory I bring in alaukika sannikarisha. In my mind I see that. So what I saw in my mind, I bring and superimpose on this. Then I misunderstood this as something else. Anyata. So anyata khyati. Anirvachaniya khyati, according to Advaita Siddhanta, we have seen that. So you cannot say this is real or unreal, the superimposition. The appearance looks like real. When knowledge comes, it disappears. It's unreal. So you cannot say, is this real or unreal? In both ways, it is real and unreal. The sat, asat. So what about the substratum? Substratum is asat, sat, asat, vilakshanam. The appearance is appearing on the substratum. So our goal is, actually speaking, we studied whole day yesterday. Khyativada. About the appearance. So our subject matter is not the appearance. Our subject matter is substratum, actually speaking. To get the substratum, we are analyzing the appearance. How to remove the appearance from the substratum, to get substratum. Substratum is our goal to be reached. So understanding this much, Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya is moving to next point. He is giving example from our worldly transactions. From a day-to-day life, he has taken few examples. Two examples he has taken and is showing to us. Now, before that, shall we read the whole Bhashya? Whatever we have covered so far, we'll read that. Shall we do together? Together we'll do. Otherwise it will take a little more time. Together. But you are now master. Okay. Yushmat asmat pratyaya gocharayoho vishaya vishayinoho tamaprakashavat viruddha svabhavayoho itaretara bhava anupapattau siddhayam taddharmanam api sutaram itaretara bhava anupapattihi ityataha asmat pratyaya gochare vishayini chidatmake yushmat pratyaya gocharasya vishayasya taddharmanam cha adhyasah tadviparyayena vishayinah taddharmanam cha vishaye adhyaso mithya iti bhavitum yuktam tatapi anyonyasmin anyonyatmakatam anyonyadharmamscha adhyasya tare avivekena atyanta vivikta yoho dharma dharminoho mityajnana nimittaha satyandrate mithuni krutye ahamidam mamayidam iti naisargikoyam lokavyavaharaha aha koyam adhyaso nameti uchyate smritirupaha paratra purvadrishta avabhasaha tam kechit anyatra anyadharma adhyasa iti vatanti kechittu yatrayat adhyasaha tadviveka agraha nibandhano brahmayiti anyetu yatrayat adhyasaha tasya eva viparita dharma kalpanam achakshate sarvata pitu anyasya anyadharma avabhasatam na vyabhicharati. You are chanting very nicely. Are you chanting? But you are chanting very nicely, good. So every day, even when you get time in the room also, just start it. See, you have to get very familiar with this. As you read more and more and more time, you are very familiar with this. Because once in a lifetime, we get the chance to learn. So we have to make very deep relationship with this Adhyasa Bhashya. This should become a part of life. Adhyasa Bhashya should become part of life. As you read more and more time, get strengthened. Now, this is moving to next thought. Right, now. Worldly experience. To strengthen this superimposition. To support. Corroborates this or that. The superimposition. Worldly experience. Here he gives two examples. Brings two examples to understand the superimposition. Already we have studied, we have seen this. Now, తథా చ లోకే అనుభవ శుక్తికా హి రజత భాసతే ఏకశ్చంద్ర సద్వితీయవత్ ఇతి ఇన్ లోకే అనుభవ. We are seeing that. We are getting the experience in the world. Shuktikahi, shuktiha, shuktika, shell. The shell. Shuktikahi rajatavat avabhasate. Shines like silver piece. 2 days we are seeing that. Why he is telling like this? Already we have seen, actually now only Bhagavan brings this idea. శుక్తికాహి రజతవత అవభాసతే. యాక్చువల్లీ ది శుక్తిక షైనింగ్ లైక్ రజత. రజత మీన్స్ సిల్వర్. ద సిల్వర్ ఇస్ అపియరెన్స్, శుక్తి ఇస్ ద బేస్, ద ఒరిజినల్ థింగ్. దిస్ ఇస్ వన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. అనదర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ హీ గివ్స్ ఏకశ్చంద్ర, ఓన్లీ వన్ మూన్ ఇస్ దేర్. ఈవెన్ ఇన్ అమెరికా ఆల్సో ఓన్లీ వన్ మూన్. ఆస్ట్రేలియా ఓన్లీ వన్ మూన్. యు గో ఎనీ country, same moon, yeah, thank you. Only one moon and same moon. Wherever we go, only one. Ekas chandra, one chandra, sadvitiyavat iti. Sometimes we see there is two moons. Sadvitiyavat iti. Yeah, when we get problem in our eyes, we get this two moons. Sometimes you don't know, 5 moons. Then we are referring other person. You see, is this one or two? This person says 2 moons. So this person, 10 I think. He has got more problem. Right, reflection. So the example is Suktika, Rajatavata Avabhasate, one example. And another example, one moon, what is that? Looking as two. Actually, only one. The fact is one. But we see that there is two moons. The fact is Shuktika, we see silver and the Shuktika. This is the problem. This is Pradibhasika Satyam, what we have studied yesterday. Pradibhasika, in the loke, tatacha loke. Loke means here, vyavaharika. In the vyavaharika, where we are doing a transaction, all the transactions, there we see the examples. Shuktika, rajatavatavabhasate. So we have to add one more, the examples we know that. Ghost in the post, on the post, and snake on the rope, all the things he can. But why he has given two examples here? The technical name is given for these two examples. So one is called Sopadika, Adhyasa. The another one is called Nirupadika Adhyasa. Again, problem started now. Different name is given there. No, very simple only. Very simple. We are not bringing more and more technical terms of this, the subject. Very simply, and wherever it is needed, we are bringing that. Now see, Sopadika Adhyasa, Nirupadika Adhyasa. There are two Adhyasas. Actually, one Adhyasa only. Excuse me. Only one of the, we are studying only one Adhyasa means superimposition. So he has given the two examples. Same Adhyasa, two ways how to look this. How the superimposition is happening. According to that, the name is given. The superimposition is same only. Sopadi. Upadi means what? The conditioning. Upadi means conditioning. Sopadika. With condition. Nirupadika. Without condition. Now in Sopadika Adhyasa, we see this crystal and hibiscus example. The hibiscus is a red color. The red color hibiscus. The crystal is no color. We cannot say even white color also. There is no color. Crystal, that's all. Crystal color. Crystal, that's all. There is no color for a crystal. Sometimes we have the Shivalinga in temple. They offer hibiscus. This hibiscus behind the crystal, behind the crystal, when you see this Shivalinga or crystal, it looks like a red color. So one quality is what's that superimposed on other that object, and this object is looking like that object. They call it sopadika. Actually, the conditioning from outside, the condition from external, the external factor conditioned here. They call it sopadika. Now this is svapadika, that's all. You just leave it. Forget it. So what I do, you read, forget it. Don't bring that here. You understand this as it is. Crystal doesn't have any color. Because of this hibiscus, you get crystal color as red. That's all. The conditioning is from outside, not from crystal. Crystal is not creating any red color here. So that is the point here. Crystal doesn't create any color itself. Because of this hibiscus from outside factor, it gets the red color. It's called swapadi. The conditioning from outside. Is it okay? In the same way, this moon example, Sadhutiyat moon example, belongs to swapadika adhyasa. Because moon is, what is that? One. Because we see moon because we may have some cataract problem. This cataract is outside the, or the outside in external factor creates double moon. Moon doesn't create any problem. Getting it? The outside external factor creates the problem in the moon. Swapadik. Sometimes we have, very rarely we have a cataract. Otherwise, suppose you take this finger and push this ball here. In people also you get 4-5 avatars. One man looks like 10. You just press this ball, then you get double. The factor is external, that is the point. The external factors make the thing as what a second or a thing or that you look or the, you see some superimposition on that. Instead of the original thing, you see some other thing. What is the reason? When you see the reason is external, not internal. This is called swapadika or that adhyasa. Adhyasa happens because of the external factor. That's all. This is called swapadika adhyasa. Very, very simple. Nirupadika adhyasa, there is no external thing. No external thing plays role here. The rope itself is appearing as what is that? Snake. The shell itself is appearing as a shell, silver. That's all. So we are not pressing our eyeball. The snake comes. Not like that. The snake comes from without any external factor. Now here you should not bring because of the avidya only you see. No, don't go there. I know you are trying to go there. Stop your thinking process. In some places, we should not cross the line and understand. Just understand as it is. The shell creates itself, the silver. There's no external factor is involved. Nirupadika. No upadide. No external factor. The robe creates itself. You're getting it? In the case of sopadika, the crystal and the red color the crystal is getting because of the red color is behind the crystal. You get the double moon because unnecessarily you press it, you get it. Or some or that puro karma, we get the cataract. At least I get two, you are getting four moons. So much of a cataract. Is it okay? Okay. Anyway, whether it is swapadika or nirupadika, the real is damaged there. The real thing is not seen as it is. Whether it is sopadika or nirupadika. With the external factor, without external factor, something, the reality is what is that covered with appearance. That is a point. Okay, even when we see examples outside, is what is the categorizing very nicely. This is sopadika, nirupadika, with the external factor, without external factor. Very, very clear thought. Very, very clearly they are bringing thought and dividing it. This is sopadika. Whenever you see, this is sopadika. Whenever you see without or that external, nirupadika. Very clearly they are bringing the thought. Thought by thought. There's no confusion at all. Unless we make some effort to make out the confusion. I tried my best to confuse myself. When we make or say effort to confuse, otherwise they are very, very clear in the system. Getting it? So when you understand in this packet, you just understand as it is. You should not bring any other thing. This is sopadika, nirupadika. That's all. The thought is clear. First you understand the thought, let it be with us very strongly. You just own the thought. When time comes, we will take this thought, we will compare with other. Otherwise, as you study here, if you bring other thought, finished. Getting it? So before making the payasam, you should not bring the, what is that, yalakai? Cardamom. Pilaj, yeah. So you should not bring. You finish the, what is that, payasam, then you put. As you are making the payasam, you boil the water, put the elich. So you have to put this in the final stage. I hope you are getting it. So thought by thought. You understand this, swapadika, nirupadika, that's all. Whichever you see. Suppose you see more, for the example. You see more example, then you categorize. He has given two categories, swapadika, nirupadika, whichever you see. And you put in this category. This is swapadika and this is nirupadika. If you have doubt, you put inside, in between these two. I do not know whether it is swapadika or nirupadika, put it there. When time comes, it will join somewhere else. Anuvachanam. Superimposition itself is anuvachanam according to Advaita tradition. But the superimposition happens because of upadhi without upadhi. Upadhi means here the avidya is ultimate cause. We are not touching that. We are not touching the avidya here. The external and without. That's the point. You understood. Okay. Now he has given the thought. Now when you go there, sometimes he cannot bring so many examples in one place. No, not needed at all. Two examples I have given. Now you take this thought. Now you go and learn more. So like this, the thought is given for us. The freedom is given. Now whatever we see, now we can, we know how to put in into these two categories. That's all. Okay? Chalimo? This is Swapadika Adhyasa. Actually, the moon should be double moon here. Because I don't get that kind of picture. That's why the reflection I have. This is not actually speaking Adhyasa. So you imagine that this moon is here, okay? Please imagine. Because it's a reflection, this is not Adhyasa. Because I tried to search to get double moon. Double means nothing. I have to work in the Photoshop then bring double moon. I don't have time. So this is a reflection. Please you imagine. Please you superimpose the second moon. Okay? Right. And this is Nirupadi. Yesterday we went to go to that beach and we got this shell only. Nirupadika. This is a shell. So actually this is a round, what is that? Silver coin. So no Indian silver coin is available in the image. That's why I took it to Canada. So you have to press it, oval shape. The shape also showed what the coin said. So this is the real and this is what that. Superimposed. Okay, this is Nirupadika. Now you understand. Now going to thought 6. Okay? This is very nice thought now. Very nice logic he brings now. You will enjoy this thought. This is completely clear to you. Okay, very completely clear. The fire is subject. Otherwise, you call it asmat, I, or self, vishayi, prakasha, light. That is object. Yushmat, not self, vishaya, tamar, darkness. This is completely clear. First two examples, okay? So, you consider this fire as subject and iron ball is object. Is it clear? Very clear. This is subject now. The subject is rope. The object is shell. The subject is shell. And the silver coin is object. Is this clear? No. No. Clear. Now so far you understood subject means this. An object is outside. Is it okay? Okay. In two ways you have to understand. When you say subject and object, you don't understand. Please, you don't understand. Subject means I, okay? Object means other than I. Don't understand like that. You will come little later. Are you okay? Now you get the point. Subject means, or the subject object you take outside of the, what is that? World. Don't come here. Fire is subject. The ball is object. The rope is subject. The snake is object. The subject, the rope is outside of ourselves. Are you getting it? Rope is lying down here and snake also lying down outside. Now outside only we give the name, this is subject, this is object. Is it okay? So the subject also, what is that? Lying outside. Object also lying outside. Now you take shell and silver. This shell is subject, what is that? This is looking like, what is that? The symbol of, what is that? Bharat Petroleum, eh? But this is a shell, okay? It's looking like cauliflower. Should be like this one. Okay, shell. And this is silver coin. India coin, okay? India coin. Shell. Shell. This is subject, okay? Subject. Object. Okay. Subject and object. This subject is, you see a subject is outside. Outside the world, you see. Outside of the world, subject. And this is object, is it okay? Actually speaking, both are objects only. Now you get the point. Actually speaking, both are objects. The same way, rope also object, snake also object. Shell also object, coin also object. Now for our study, we consider this object as subject. Are you with me?
Yes.
For our study purpose, we have taken, actually this is also object, this is also object. For our study purpose, we call this object as a subject and this object as an object. Yeah. The original object and superimposed object. Are you getting it? So this original object, you call it subject. And this is object. Is this clear? If it is clear, then we will go next. Okay. Now this object, this superimposed object, we see on subject. Is it okay? This is very clear. So in the world of experience, we see one object is seen on other object. Clear. The superimposed object is called object. The object on which superimposed is called subject. Very clear. So snake is object. The rope is, in the same way, iron ball is object. Fire is subject. It's very clear. Is this okay? Now, he says that, sir, when you superimpose the silver or snake on another object outside. Is it okay? It's very clear. So I can understand very clearly whether it is nirupadika or sopadika, you superimpose one object on another object outside. The object on which you superimpose, you call it subject. The superimposed object is called object. This is very, very clear, sir. There is no doubt in it. Are you okay? Now, the problem comes, sir. I understand your theory of superimposition. But my question, here the subject is inside, sir. Object is outside, sir. Right? Are you getting it or not? When outside object you superimpose on the outside, it's very clear. But how can you superimpose outside object on yourself subject? Getting it? How can you superimpose body, mind and intellect on Atma, which is the innermost subject, which is impossible? This is a very new thought. You just forget all those things. Anyway, you have forgotten, but forget. Don't bring any earlier idea there. The idea is, the question is, outside object can be superimposed on outside object, that's all. Rope also object, snake also object. When we study very technically, we come outside, we say snake is object, so rope is subject. So we study like that. Actually, both are objects outside. Now here, my question is, the outside object, body is object, mind also subtle object, and intellect also subtle object. All the objects outside, okay, how can you superimpose those things on the subject, or on Atma or self, which is impossible? Getting it? But so far in our look, now he has told, loke anubhava. What is the experience of the outside world? You superimpose one object on another object. This is called superimposition. I can understand very clearly. There is no problem in it. But how can you superimpose the object on the self, which is the innermost thing? Do you like the question or not?
Yes.
Very powerful thought. Very new thought, powerful thought. The Purva Paksha, this is called the opposite person locked. Then Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya has to bring the answer for this question. We should like the question. Nice question. The question is very powerful, very nice also. Have you got it? You understood the question? Outside is okay, but the outside thing, how can you superimpose inside? The innermost. That is formless. Are you getting it? Formless and innermost thing, how can you, what is the superimpose? This is the idea. Now, how can you superimpose body, mind, intellect? This body, mind, intellect. All this put together, okay? This object on subject. Actually, this is the real subject, this is the real object. So far, we have studied in our. Yeah. Actually speaking, when we say subject, we complete. What is that? Unanimously, we know that subject means self, Atma. Objects means body, mind and intellect. We understood, we heard many, many times. We gave nice talks also on this topic. But here, the new thought, actually speaking, two objects outside. This is object, subject. One object can be superimposed on another object. That superimposed is called a subject. The outside, okay. Now, actually, without understanding, without asking this question, we gave many talks also. Very good. Actually, real subject and real object. Here the question, outside can be superimposed on outside. How outside can be superimposed on inside, the innermost? This is the question. This innermost subject, asmat, self, vishaya and prakasha, same thing. That outside object, yushmat, not self, vishaya, tamas, same point is repeating here. Only the object is getting changed, okay? Now, are you okay? Now this is the question, you understood the question? You like the question? Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya brought this question. So then Adhyasa Bhashya would say, how? The very peculiar thought he brings. How he testing this. The outside object imposing on outside subject, we know. That's, we are familiar with this. And this also we are familiar. Superimposition of body, mind, intellect on the inner self, this also we are familiar. But how he brings together outside and inside very nicely. How he arranges the thought. Very nicely he is arranging the thought and brings idea. How can he superimpose? Because one body can be superimposed on another body. Or one mind can be superimposed. So one man can be misunderstood as another man. This is body superimposition, mind superimposition, intellect. But body, mind, intellect you superimpose on innermost, which is not possible. The idea itself is not possible. Because we heard, whenever we hear, we are locked with many thoughts. Because in the earlier case yesterday we studied. Yesterday we studied, the similar things can be made superimposition. This is the idea we got. We are blocked with some idea. Whenever we get superimposition, the similarity should be there. This is the idea. But the idea is broken yesterday. Dissimilar thing also can make superimposition. Is it okay? In the same way. The same kind of thought. Same style of thought here. We should not say the other outside object only can be superimposed on outside object. No. Outside can be superimposed on inside. This is a special thought. I hope you're following this. Because we got so many of the blocks. Only outside can be, no, inside also. How? He has to convince now the audience. He brings a very good, nice answer also. Is it okay? This is the inner self. Inner self, the nature of inner self, Prakasha Swarupa. This is Drik, Chit and Pratyagatman. So whatever the name, by name you call it. Prakasha Swarupa, Pratyagatman, Drik. Those who studied Drik Drishyavaka very clearly, the Drik is a seer. Chit. This is the nature of inner self. How can you superimpose the outside object into innermost self? It's a question. Okay, shall we move? When you reflect, you get very power, very nice. We appreciate the thought. Shall we go? Now. This is outside. Now see, this is outside object. Outside object can be superimposed on outside. This outside object, snake, can be superimposed on outside object, rope. The outside object, BMI, should be superimposed on outside only, actually speaking, the same thought. But suddenly the break comes there. How can you superimpose the outside object, BMI, to the self-subject? This is a question there. Okay, now he asks, now you come to that. Because originally we have to study. The thought we understood by seeing this kind of examples. Now, original. The Adhyasa Bhashya he has written. Katam punaha pratyagatmani avishaye adhyaso vishaye tadharmanam. Now, katam punaha, how can? How? Katam punaha, pratyagatmani. Pratyagatmani means in the self, seventh case. In the self, pratyagatmani, avishaya, that is not vishaya. Pratyagatma, the self is vishayi actually. Vishayi. Actually, that is not avishaya. Avishaya. That is not vishaya there. Come. This is Pratyagatma, okay? Pratyagatma. They take only body. This is more than enough. Okay? This is more than enough. So don't take mind and intellect. Extra load you have to give to mind. Only body, that's all. Now, katam punaha. This is Pratyagatma, the innermost self. Pratyagatmani. Avishaye. This is Vishaya. Vishaya. This is Vishaya. This is not Vishaya. Therefore, this is in not Vishaya. This is Vishaya actually. Because Vishaya only can be superimposed on another Vishaya. Only the rope, the snake can be superimposed on the rope also Vishaya, snake also Vishaya, outside. Both are objects only. Only object can be superimposed on another object. Again, that's why he is telling this is not Vishaya. Not Vishaya means Avishaya. Seventh case, Avishaye. Pratyagatma is not Vishaya. Are you getting it? Pratyagatma is Vishayi. You getting it? Avishaye. This is not Vishaya. How you superimpose one object on another object like that? That case cannot be or that applied here. This is Pratyagatma and Avishaye. Avishaye. Adhyaso. Adhyasaha means you superimpose this. Adhyasaha. Adhyasa, what you are superimposing? Vishaya. The object is Vishaya. Vishaya and Taddharmana. You are superimposing this body and its attribute. Vishaya and Taddharmana. Adhyasa. How you are superimposing? One Vishaya can be superimposed on other Vishaya. Outside. Silver can be superimposed on shell. Here, body is Vishaya. But Pratyagatma is not Vishaya. But Vishaya is superimposed on Avishaya, meaning Vishaya. Vishayi, Vishayi. Simply with the words they are playing, actually you understood. You understood Vishaya can be superimposed on another Vishaya. In the same way, this is Vishaya and this is Vishayi. But you are superimposing Vishaya on Vishayi. Vishayi, you can call it Avishaya also. Are you getting it? Vishaya is, other name of Vishaya is Avishaya. This is not Vishaya. Because this is Vishayi. Getting it? So this is Pratyagatma, Avishaya. Pratyagatmani Avishaya, you are bringing this Vishaya and Dharma on this. Is it okay? Katam punaha Pratyagatmani Avishaya Adhyasu. How you are doing the superimposition, which is Vishaya and Tad Dharma. The first line you understood. Now, Sarvohi Puravastita Vishaye Puravastita Yeva Vishaye Vishayantaram Adhyasati Adhyasyati Adhyasyati Adhyasyati. Is not there? Adhyasyati. Okay. Sarvohi. It's all. Puravastita eva vishaye. Puravastita in front of. There should be some object in front of us. Puravastita eva vishaye. Vishayantaram adhyasati. Vishayantaram means other vishaya. Other object can be superimposed on other objects which is lying in front of us. Are you getting it? So puravastita vishaye means in front of us whatever the object is lying down. On that only we impose another. Vishayantaram adhyasati. Very clear. So whatever we have spoken, we are reading now. That's all. This is a new thought. So there should be some object in front of us. Puravastita vishaye. Vishayantara means another object. Adhyasati means superimposed. This is the law of the life. We are blocked with that law. That's why the question comes. So throughout the life, we see this kind of experience. Whenever you superimpose, you should have one object here, one object there. That is Vishayantaram. This is Vishaya. Vishayantaram, Vishaya, Adhyasyati. Where is this happening? In front of us, Puravastite Eva. Okay, Sarvohi. All people in all places. Sarvohi, Puravastite Eva Vishaya, Vishayantaram, Adhyasyati. Is it clear? Say clear. Yeah. All right. Now, Again, last line you have to, actually speaking now, excuse me, you understood everything, you know all, but here the words are playing, trying to, what is that, twisting the word to get the meaning this way and that way, that's all. How you make this, what do you call, something you roast, what do you call, parota? What do you call the? The round, convex, concave, the shape of the, what do you call it? Thali, thali, what do you call it? Thali or? Pan, pan, something you put and you roll here and there, you roast. Rumali? Rumali roti. Take rumali roti and roast like this. This side, that side, that side, you just, you do something and roast it, getting it. When you roast, you will not do very soft method. You will not. You roll, go this side, that side, and go the roast this side. Are you getting it? Put that big over there. Roasting. You must have seen near some railway station or bus stand. Opposite you were the bus stand, the hotel. The parota, like this, playing with words actually. You understood. Pratyagatmani avishaye, vishaye, vishaye, and tadharmanam, what do you want actually? What do you want? Tell me. This is subject and object. This is superimposed, and in and most of that's all. Leave it. I understood. Actually, point, you got the point. You hear the words are there to play here and there. That's all. Don't worry about it. Now, the last line you see, again, very interesting line. Yushmat pratyaya apetasya cha pratyagatmanaha avishayatvam bravishi. So what you are, bravishi means what you are telling. Now see, now. Yushmat pratyaya apetasya. Now see, excuse me. This is yushmat. This is asmat. You are very clear now. Now is the subject and the object. This is asmat, this is yushmat. Then, yushmat pratyaya apetasya. This is not yushmat. You're getting it? This is the yushmat. Only yushmat can be superimposed on other yushmat, which is called asmat. Outside. You're getting it? So, this is yushmat, this is not yushmat. This is not yushmat. But in outside, one yushmat can be superimposed on other yushmat. But here, one yushmat can be superimposed on the innermost asmat. Are you getting it? Actually speaking, this is the real asmat. The innermost self, atma. This is yushmat pratyaya apetasya. This is not yushmat. Then what is called asmat? This is what from yesterday you are telling. Yes. Are you getting it? You are telling this way and that way. What is this yushmat? Asmat. This is really this is asmat. But we can call it other way. This is not yushmat. Are you getting it? I am simply playing the words actually. This is not cake. That means this is biscuit. Are you getting it? I'm not telling this is cake. It is not, you don't talk like this. This is not cake, that's all. That means what? This is biscuit. So both the way this is same only. Yeah, correct, you understood. You take biscuit there. You are telling this is not what I told. Cake, not cake. This is biscuit. Are you getting it? This is biscuit. This is not cake. Yeah, this is not cake. Then what it is? Biscuit. Yeah, both are same only. This is not cake also right. This is biscuits also right. You get the point? So here the point, yushmat prati apetasya means, this is not yushmat means what? Asmat, that's all. So you can say, straightly you show the biscuit and you tell, this is biscuit. This is one way of telling the biscuit, okay. In other way, because you want to create some... This is not what that. This is biscuit, you can say. And this is not cake also, you can say. They're getting in other way. This is asmat, directly you are telling. Because you don't want to create some problem in your house. That's why this is asmat, finished. But in the other way, why he is telling here, unnecessarily he is bringing, this is not what that, yushmat. Actually, he can tell this is asmat. Why unnecessarily Acharya is bringing, this is not yushmat? Because on the outside, only yushmat can be superimposed on other yushmat. But you are telling like that. But here, the yushmat is, what that? Superimposed on asmat, which is not yushmat. Are you getting it? Actually speaking, very interesting. Now see, the Bhashya, Brahmasutra is very interesting. The same truth is, what that? Presented in another way. It's not difficult actually. Not difficult, it's interesting. You're getting it? Very interesting actually. The same truth you are learning in a different angle. Actually, this is asmat. But now we are telling this is not yushmat. That means what? Asmat, that's all. Then you can say this is directly asmat. No, no. The context is needed that you have to say this is not asmat. Are you getting it? Not yushmat. So, yushmat pratyaya apetasya. This is not yushmat. Yushmat pratyaya apetasya. This is not yushmat. Pratyagatmanaha. Then what is this? Innermost self. Pratyagatmanaha. Avishayatvam pravishi. Now see, this is not, what that? Vishaya. Vishaya. This is not vishaya. Avishaya. Are you getting it? This is not vishaya means what? Avishaya. Avishaya means what? Vishayi. Getting very interesting presentation. Presentation is very interesting actually. Actually, what is that? Atma. So directly, if you say this is Atma, this is Pratyagatma, directly you can say, what is this? Atma. What is this? Innermost self. What is this? Pratyagatma. Getting it? What is this? Vishayi. What is this? Asmat. But you can say other way. This is not Vishaya. Avishaya. This is not Yushmat. Getting it? This is not Yushmat. This is not Vishaya. And this is Pratyagatma. Getting it? You can say in both the ways. But in this context, so you have to say, this is Avishaya. This is Yushmat. This is not Yushmat. Even though this is not Yushmat, Avishaya, you are superimposing Yushmat, Vishaya into this. How it is possible? That's the question. Why he is unnecessarily bringing this is not Yushmat, this is not Vishaya? Because on the outside, you impose one, superimpose one Yushmat into other Yushmat. One Vishaya into other Vishaya. But this is not Vishaya, this is not Yushmat. Therefore, how can you superimpose one Yushmat onto this Yushmat? This is not Yushmat. Are you getting it? This is not Vishaya. So, avishayasya, Yushmat pratyaya apetasya, pratyagatmanaha katham. Getting it? Actually, interesting thought. It's not difficult. It's very interesting, actually. Very, very nice thought to enjoy this. How he presents the Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya? Apetasya? Without that, Yushmat Pratya, this is not the I notion. This is not thou notion. So being not thou notion. Without, yeah. The opposite of Yushmat. You got it? You got it? Yeah, without. This is not Asmat. Therefore, Yushmat Pratya Apetasya. Without what that? Yushmat. Opposite of Yushmat. Have you understood? Yes. I got forget. Bravishi means you are telling like that. Bravishi. You are telling. He is asking himself, you are telling. Just now you told that this is Avishaya. Avishaya. You are telling this is Avishaya. You are telling this is not Yushmat. Even though it's not Yushmat, not Vishaya, you are superimposing this on that. How? This is a question. Why this question comes? Because in the outside world, sarvo puravasthita vishaya eva vishayantaram adhyasyati. Puravasthita vishaya, in one vishaya, on one vishaya, other vishaya can be superimposed. One yushmat, this is the object. The object is called, what is that? Yushmat. Other Yushmat can be superimposed. This is not Yushmat, this is not Vishaya. Are you getting it? Not Yushmat means what? Yushmat Pratya Apetasya. Ha Vishayasya. Pratyagatmanaha. This is innermost self. Then how can you superimpose one Yushmat onto which is not Yushmat? Vishaya onto which is not Vishaya. This is a question. But very interestingly, great thought actually. This is the brilliant intellect. Gurudev used to call Bhagavan Adi Shankar is embodiment of intelligence. Now you see, directly, how he thinks, how he puts the idea. Without. Getting it? Very fantastic. But the answer we have to get, sir. Sir, the question is very interesting, sir. What is the answer, sir? You have to answer that. But the question is very nice, very powerful. Answer also should be very convincing there. When he brings this kind of a question, he brings a powerful answer also. Answer is there. Objection answered, Your Honor. Okay? Answer is very interesting there. You enjoy the subject? Yes, it's not powerful, yes?
Yes.
See the thinking process of Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya. Oh, in Adhyasa Bhashya. I'm not telling this is very new idea to you. Actually, you know everything. You know, enough of experience you have from the world. Enough of experience. That is more than enough to understand the idea. You don't worry about the words of Sanskrit. Just leave it. No need to quote many slokas here. And excuse me, leave it. That is for those who teach. For them only you have to quote here and there and you make the people... No. For real sadhaka, to walk in this, to get more clear, the idea you have to catch. The core idea is important. You understood. So what is the question? You understood. Then you are able to explain this. Or you are able to reflect on this. This is the core point. I understood. Another object can be superimposed on another object. The object is called Yushmat technically. Another object also Yushmat. One Yushmat can be superimposed on another Yushmat outside. Puravasyata Vishayeva. This is the thought block. This is the experience we see. But here what you are telling, Yushmat is superimposed on Asmat, which is not Yushmat. Which is not what the Vishaya. One Vishaya can be superimposed on other Vishaya. Here the Vishaya of body superimposed on Avishaya, which is Vishayi, which is Pratyagatma. How this is possible? This is a question. Okay, very good. Thank you. So we'll continue this in the next class. No, see, why they are calling like that? Why they are calling like that? Why Gurudev is praising him? Now you see. You're getting it? Now you got very great chance to see Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya directly. Very direct. Because the great saints are praising him because they are worshipping him. That's a different matter. I see myself this great idea. How he presents. How he presents. Great intelligence. Okay? So 11 o'clock we'll see. We'll continue the answer. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.